Right now, you are doing things the hard way, manually sorting your emails, manually copying data from one tool to another tool, one sheet to another sheet, manually updating your spreadsheets, manually posting social media content or content on your blog post, spending hours every single day on all these repetitive tasks. What if I told you that there is a way that you can save 10, 20, even 30 hours every week without working harder? Instead of you working for the task would be working for you. Welcome to my course on AI automation, the ultimate time-saving, stress-killing, and productivity-boosting superpower of the modern world. I can promise you one thing, that if you follow along me in this course, by the end of it, you would have created your own powerful automation system or workflow without writing a single line of code. And no, you won't need a PhD in computer science or sacrifice your weekends learning Python or other programming languages. And no, your job won't be replaced by AI unless you miss this opportunity. Let's get real for a second. How does a normal workday look like for most people? Well, first thing in the morning, you see your inbox and hundreds of emails are there. Half of them are junk. Many of them are got it, thanks kind of replies or emails, but you still have to go through them manually, sort them out, and look for the most important information that is applicable for you. If you are working in the data entry field, well, you're copying manually all the data from one sheet to another sheet, worrying about all the formulas that are correct or not correct. Have you made any kind of manual mistake? Will it goof up any kind of dashboards for the analyst or BI people? Or you may be a content creator like me, posting content on various social media platforms, repurposing the same thing, maybe like a blog post or a video announcement to various social media channels, all doing it manually. Hey, it's 2025. Why are we still doing all these things manually? Every single task steals your precious time. And the worst part is, as the business grows, the worse it gets. At this rate, you are not working for yourself, rather you are working for your to-do list. Ever feels like that the task manager is owning you rather than the other way around? But it doesn't have to be like this always. Automation nowadays has become more of a necessity rather than a convenience. Now imagine this. Instead of spending hours every week on sorting your emails, what if an AI assistant sorts all the emails, find out what exactly is important for you in all those emails, mark them, label them, and send a summarized version to your text message or a WhatsApp message or a Telegram message to you that this is the summary of all your emails. These are the actions that you have to take. These are the events that are already planned for you. If you are into data entry, what if the AI assistant is already following all the rules that are there, updating all those spreadsheets, updating all those numbers and the dashboards, and even summarizes everything and sends a message to the BI or the data analysts? And if you are a content creator, instead of you logging in, the AI assistant is formatting all the posts, repurposing them for different social media platforms, posting them, even generating blogs and content and saving them as draft for you so that you can review and post it. All this is happening without you lifting a finger. Everything is automated from zero to the end. Won't that be a great reality to live in? With automation, you get back hours every week into your life so that you can focus more on strategy, more on creativity. Automation is not just about saving time. It is freeing yourself from those boring, mundane, repetitive manual work and try to focus upon how you can grow your business, how you can grow as a professional, how you can grow your skill, how you can focus on strategy, creativity, so that you focus on what you deserve. Maybe you just focus or get that time back into your life, to your loved ones, so that you can spend more time with them. And that's exactly what we will unlock in this course, and you will learn how to build all these automation workflows without writing a single line of code. Now I know what you must be thinking. All this automation talk sounds very interesting, but how do I start on this journey? You must be thinking, another tech tutorial, another course, another automation tool. Well, if you are thinking that way, Trust me, this is not going to be the regular tech tutorial or a software walkthrough where you would see me click on various screen parts and learn from it. This course is designed to take you on a real journey from beginner to an automation expert, all by doing hands-on labs, creating AI workflows, and following industry best practices. By the end of this course, you would not have just learned what automation is, how it can help, rather you would have created workflows that would save time for you in real world. Now let's look at the entire course outline, which is divided into 9 different sections. In the first section of this course, we'll start with absolute basics. Even if you have never automated anything before, the introduction lays the foundation of what is automation, why it matters, what is actually n8n. We'll give you an overview of it, and then we'll talk about how it compares with other industry automation tools such as Zapier and make.com, and how the open source nature of n8n makes it apart from them. In the second section, we'll get started with n8n. We'll talk about the installation process, whether you should self-host, whether you should use the cloud version of it, what are the key differences. We'll understand the basic UI of n8n platform. We'll move on to the key concepts, where we'll talk about nodes, workflows, triggers, and by this time we will start creating a very simple first automation workflow, more like whenever a form is submitted, you get an automated email. Then we'll talk about how the data flows in n8n. We'll talk about JSONs, lists, items, and finally we'll close this beginner section by talking about some of the more important nodes which are there. And don't worry if you're not understanding what I'm talking about, nodes, triggers, workflows, you're going to deep dive into all these concepts with hands-on labs and practical experiences so that you follow along very easily in this entire course. So stay tuned. By the end of these two sections, you'll be confidently building some simple automations and ready to dive deeper into the concepts. Now that you have built some basic workflows, it's time to level up. In this section, you will learn about connecting Google Sheets, Slack, Notion, CRMs, and other external apps. We will talk about the advanced logic concepts such as if-else conditions, loops, how the branching works in the workflows, what is the node execution order, how can you split them, how can you merge different branches. We'll also talk about what are expressions, what is a code node, what is an HTTP node, and why it is used. Then we are going to talk about how you can pin data, edit outputs so that you can build the workflows in a faster manner. Then we move on to sub workflows, which is more like how you can create small reusable workflows which can be used in a bigger workflow. This is where the reusability concepts will kick in. Finally, we'll close this section of deep dive concepts on n8n by handling files in workflows, how you can handle them, how you can work with them, how you can compress them, how you can post them. Most of the thing in today's world revolves around files, images, videos, documents, whatever you can think of, you are storing data on files. So it is important to learn the concepts how you can handle files in your automation workflows. The fourth section of this course is all about error handling and debugging, and by the end of this section you will learn how you can gracefully handle errors in your workflow execution, how you can debug them and fix the failed execution, and finally we'll also talk about error handling workflows, which is more like as soon as an error occurs, somebody gets a message, somebody gets an email. Very important concept in building resilient workflows. The fifth section of this course is more like a hands-on project where we will be building a real-world workflow end-to-end, leveraging all the concepts that we have learned so far in this course. By the end of this section, you will be building some smart, error-proof automations that run on autopilot. Now that you are an automation workflow expert, it's time to harness the power of AI and build some smarter workflows for you. In section number 6 of this course, you will learn about how to use OpenAI, ChatGPT APIs in your workflows to make them smarter. We will talk about an automation content generation system, an end-to-end workflow which can power your blogs with AI. You can generate social media captions through AI, and how you can schedule your content for bulk posting. Then in the next lesson, we'll talk about how you can build AI-driven decision-making workflows such as automating approvals, fraud detection, or process optimization. In the next lesson, we'll take a hands-on project on automating customer response and summarization. Then in the 7th section of this course, we are going to bring everything together what we have learned and build a real world example or real world workflow for a content creator where you can create a faceless YouTube channel running on autopilot and powered by AI. Won't that be a great output for you in this course? That you will be able to build your own faceless YouTube channel which is running on its own, powered by AI, powered by automation, without you writing a single line of code. Well, we are not going to stop over there, and in the 8th section of this course I'm going to talk about the n8n enterprise grade features, which talks about how you can collaborate with your team members if you want to scale your organization or AI automation agency, how you can share your workflows, how you can manage different credentials, as we would have seen that we have to create so many credentials to so many different services, what is about security, user management, advanced monitoring. So we'll close this section, and finally in the last section, which is conclusion and next steps, I'm going to talk about what are some of the industry best practices, what could be some of the biggest takeaways from this course for you, what could be the next steps that you can implement, and how we can stay connected in my private community so that we can learn from each other in this AI automation journey. This is just the beginning. I'll see you in the next lesson, where we'll start the magic of AI automation world.